Good morning. Welcome to this live session. So I'm Sifu Amin Wu. I'm here in California, San Francisco Bay Area Peninsula. And this is my Tai Chi studio. And I just had my first live class in person and online on Zoom classes. 10 minutes ago, I just had a class. First class for this fall session. Then, yeah, now I'm happy to meet you guys online on the YouTube to talk about the Wu-Style Tai Chi. So on the an hour ago, I was doing the Tai Chi Qigong flow exercise with students to practice the general fundamental Tai Chi form. Then it's mostly Yang style Tai Chi, fundamental skills and some health Qigong exercise. So now in this specific session, I would like to introduce the Wu style Tai Chi. If you're online, if you're able to test in common area, please let me know if you know Wu style Tai Chi before, or if it's the first time you heard about Wu-Style Tai Chi, okay? So first of all, I'm a specialist Tai Chi instructor for Wu-Style Tai Chi. I'm fifth generation disciple for Wu-Style. And I've been learning Wu-Style Tai Chi for Tai Chi train, Tai Chi weapon, sword, broadsword, and all the Wu-Style series ever since 30 years ago, I believe. About 30 years ago. Then, yeah, my Shifu, my master, he is Master Li Bingzi. Yeah, I'm very lucky able to learning Wu-Style Tai Chi from him. Then he used to be in Beijing. Then, yeah, he just passed away a year ago, and I just went to Beijing to visit his cemetery this summer. Yeah, it's very sad. He's no longer here anymore. But I was very lucky able to learn from him since 30 years ago. Okay, so Wu-Style Tai Chi. So we have five major style of Tai Chi. The most popular one, maybe everybody know, you might see the Yang style Tai Chi 24 form or 48 form more, and a lot of people know Chen style Tai Chi a lot. Then Chen style Tai Chi is most original, and after that, so Master Yang Lu Chan developed the Yang style Tai Chi based on Chen style from Chen village. Then later, Wu-Style Tai Chi is after Yang style. So they all related. They all have the same or similar main concept. But each style, and after, then we have Chen style, Yang style, Wu-Style, and we also have Hao style, which is a Wu, another Wu. So in Chinese word, Wu and Wu is sound same, but a different word. Then that's why for overseas here we say Hao style, H-A-O. That one is another Wu style, another different Wu, okay? And then we also have Sun style, S-U-N, Sun style. So those are our major five style of Tai Chi. So here in my school, in our Tai Chi organization, we offer all different style of Tai Chi classes. We do offer Yang style, Chen style, Sun style, Wu style, all different style. Then because I'm specialist Wu style, that's why I have a lot of students really enjoy and appreciate, can learn Wu style Tai Chi with me. Okay, so why don't we do this? Just feel a little bit of the Wu style form, fundamental form. Then I will explain what is the difference. Maybe compare with Yang or compare with Chen style, that those forms most people know. Okay, I will point few main concept, main areas that way in the future, no matter you learn Wu-Style or not, at least when you see Wu-Style, you know, oh, that is a Wu-Style, or this is a correct standard form of Wu-Style, or it's not standard, okay? All right, so relax yourself if you learn Tai Chi before, or if you haven't learned any Tai Chi before, that's okay. Any style we teach from beginner level. So if you never learn any other Tai Chi, you still can learn Wu-Style from beginning. So follow the beginner level class and the intermediate, the advanced. So we have all this curricula to match each style. So for Wu-Style Tai Chi, we start with Zhanzhuang exercise. You also feet together and open step. Shoulders width, your left foot open. All right. So please relax your fingers. Roll your arms, roll up and forward slightly. And draw back. You can relax your knee, relax your hip, and rise a little bit higher. Again, completely drop, relax your fingers, grabbing back. Press your palm and gradually go higher and press down. See, when I do the rise your arms higher, I also adding some squatting my leg lower. So press the palms, squatting down, and the palms go back next to the hips. So this is a Wu-Style opening form. Usually when we do Wu-Style opening form, our palms start towards in, and the index finger leading and rotate entire arm. Then you put your energy on the wrist. So your wrist towards point forward and not your fingers. Your fingers is relaxing down. See, that's a little bit different with other style, right? So then before we go press down, we extend the fingers. Then pull back shoulder, elbow, palm. Then the palm all the way pull back to your hips. Yeah, so when we do Yang style opening form, most of the form we press down right here in front of the abdomen. But when we do Wu style, we grabbing back all the way next to the hips. Very good. Okay, let's try one more time. Breathe in. Breathe out. Nice. Very good. So your legs are relaxed. Your hips are pulled back. Your upper body is upright. Your feet are rooted, very solid. Okay, so let's try different way to rise the energy. So you can rotate your arms inward, which is your palm turned back. And your eyes can follow either side, left or right. And rise your arm all the way up. And you rotate the arms outward. And you rolling down. Sit down and you continue washing through from your front side of your body. Then you look on the other side. Continue rotate your arms. Open your back and rotate outward. And sitting down. Nice. I hope you are doing it with me. And you can try inhale when you rise. And exhale when you sit, rolling down. Inhale. Exhale. Do again, rotate your neck, loosening your neck, just like when you do the warm up. Yes, rotating the arm. Good. Okay, so now let's press our hands in the front. You feel you're holding, landing, relaxing your hands on a top of big ball. And your index fingers, thumb, slightly towards in. And you go spreading the palm out above this big ball, a smooth table, desk. And you come back in. Yeah, go out, spreading out. Then you go up. Up, and we cross the wrist and sit down. And you can stay here for a little while, or you can just stay here for a few seconds. Want to make sure your fingers rising up, your wrist connected, your elbow is towards down, connect with your knees. Your shoulders connect with your hips and crossing wrist, palm in front of your chest. Then you always can repeat from here, spread out and rise up. Nice. And you can switch your wrist in and out position when you do the repeat. Nice. Okay, this is called cross hands. And do a few more times. Open, out, wide, and rise, and cross, and sit. Toes forward, knees forward, back upright. Very nice. And press, open, up, and close. All right. So let's close a little bit. And we can bring our step back. All right, shake your leg. So this is for a few solid, we can say stationary postures training. Then later on, I will introduce some major Wu-style Tai Chi footwork, like stance. We just did the Tai Chi flow class. We learned the Yang-style Tai Chi, the bow stance, the sitting stance. Then Wu-style Tai Chi also has bow stance and a sitting stance and a horse stance. All this stance is a little bit different. We have some very important concept I need to let you know if you're interested to learning Tai Chi, okay? By the way, if there are any question, anything I need to answer online, I cannot see the comments. Everything good? All right, so you can, stop me if anything major I need to answer right now immediately. Okay, so Wu-style Tai Chi. After this, we train the open stance is all same like other stance, other style. And we do have the horse stance. Every style of Tai Chi have horse stance, right? In Wu style, horse stance is just simple. Feet side to side, open, parallel, then bending the knee, sit down halfway like riding on the horse, ride a horseback position. That's called horse stance. But in Wu-style Tai Chi, the horse stance, we never need to squat very low. Yeah, compared with like Chen style. Chen style horse stance usually is much lower. And Wu-style, the horse stance is higher. Then the another important, very, very useful, you will see use that stance a lot, is a bow stance. The specific bow stance in Wu style, we have a word in Chinese, it's called chuan zi bu. So if you learn Wu style Tai Chi, if you also know Chinese, you will hear this word a lot, chuan zi bu. Chuan is Sichuan de chuan. So because this bow stance, instead of your both your front foot is forward, your back foot is back open 45 to 60 degree for Yang style. This is the bow stance in Yang style. In Wu style, the stance is smaller, the stance is higher, and the stance is require more flexibility and strength. So, oh, why? It's smaller stance and it's higher. How come it's require more flexibility and strength? Because the Wu style, the back foot is forward. So the back foot is not open. And the back foot, the heel, all the style of Tai Chi, the heel, no one allowed to off the ground. So just like other style is stepping down, cannot peel off, but it's no open position. That's why the flexibility is required. But you can start with a small step. If it's small, it's okay, everybody can do it, okay? So let's try it if you want to feel Wu-style Tai Chi, the bow stance. So let's see where we're here. So you're shifting the weight to either side, okay? If you want to try, let's say you shift your weight to, I'm mirror image with you, I'm right, you're left, okay? You shift your weight to your left foot, then you put your front right foot in the front with heel. So again, don't go too far. If too far later, it's gonna be difficult, okay? So, put the heel first, then you lay down the foot. See your back foot still remain forward. You are not pivoting, you are not twisting, no open. So just a comfortable space forward. Then you lay down the foot, you move the weight to the front foot. And now you need to see my side view, because in Wu Style Tai Chi we say, 斜中正, so our body actually lean slightly forward. See, my upper body, instead of straight, when I do the bow stance, I have to move my weight to the my forward. And from here, my head to heel is a slant ankle. But you might see a lot of people do Wu-style Tai Chi. They say, oh, Wu-style need to lean forward. Then they go this. That's not right. Because you lean forward, there's a limitation. The limitation is here. So your nose, knee, and the toe have to be aligned. So your if it's your here, your nose is aligned with hip. Is not correct chuan zi bu. So if your nose is over, it's not correct. So your nose and the knee and the toe just about aligned. That is correct. All right. So your back foot cannot peel off. Have to be stay the heel on the ground and the both foot toes forward. And your hands can stay here next to your front leg. Yeah. So this is a bow stance for Wu style. Yeah. So let me show you the other side. See? And your eyes just naturally look forward. All right. So then what about sit back? Same thing. If you now your weight is in the front, you just need to energize your front leg, move the weight to the back leg, bending your back knee, and you just sit. This is called sitting stance. Also, we say empty front leg. The empty stance sometimes can be point with toe and also with heel. Then the back foot, usually if you're open 15 degree, less than 30 degree, it's okay. Don't worry. Yeah, you can. But if you get your back foot like this, then don't tell me you're doing Wu-style Tai Chi. Yeah, you do Yang style, that's fine. That's totally okay. You do Yang style, you do Sun style, you do... But if it's Wu-style Tai Chi, the back foot, within 30 degree, it's okay. Within 15 degree, it's better. All right? Slightly open, that's reasonable. But you need to understand that, at least. So some people, maybe your foot is naturally like this, open. You cannot go straight. Yeah, that's why it will give you some grease, you know, period area. So you can open a little bit. But this is make your hip, knee, and toe really walks same direction together. Okay, for you, when you do the shifting forward, backward, you don't have to turn. You don't have to twist. So it's more safe, protect your joints. And your step, don't need to go far. Just a small, higher, as long as you're able to handle this forward and backward without moving unnecessarily. And very important, when we do back, shift back, sitting stance, our upper body no longer lean forward. The upper body need to be upright. This is very important. So many people learning Wu style, stance. Oh, both stance, your body need to learn lean forward. But when they do sit stance, they also lean forward and become this. That's not right. Okay. Sitting stance, body upright. And back foot also try to be forward. And entire, see, arm, everything. Then your front foot can be lift up without move your body. That's your goal, okay? So from sitting stance, you go forward to bow stance. Then when you're at the bow stance, you need to get this like triangle. This is straight, this is flat on the ground, and this is oblique from here to here, okay? So bow stance, sitting stance. See, bow stance, sitting stance. Nice. So usually in our class, in our school, anyone who take a Wu-style Tai Chi class, you have to take from beginner level first. In the beginner level, we do teach the Tai Chi form, Wu-style Tai Chi 24 form. But you have to spend some time every class. Our instructor will teach you to learn to practice this stance and some fundamental movement. For example, we'll do graspy bird's tail to learn the four energy, the word of roll, press, push, pong, li, ji, an, in Wu style. And we need to practice the brush knee twist step, the pose monkey, the low xiao bu, dao nian hou, and the walking step forward, backward. Those are, we will teach you very, very detailed from beginner level class. You learn the correct standard stance, steps, essential forms. Then you got to learn each few steps, few movements every class. Okay, so let's see. We do the stance training without any hand form. Once you know the stance, then we also add in the form that when you do, this is a very common movement. We need to learn to practice, train your sitting stance and the bow stance. See, when you do the bow stance training, yeah, you want to get this energy. Make sure your shoulders parallel, hips parallel, and with a nice standard width, standard space, and a standard position. Then you stay here for a few seconds, then you sit back. So in our classes, myself and our instructors will work on each student, no matter you are online, taking a Zoom meeting class, or you are in person. We will check your position, check your movement, your hand move, your footwork, make sure you're doing correct. You are not built some unnecessary wrong habit. If you learn in the beginning, it's not correct. Later on, you finish learning the whole form. Then you go back to fix, it takes more energy, okay? So let's see. From today's session, you can learn a little bit from me, then you already can start training yourself, right? Training yourself if you're interested for Wu-Style Tai Chi. So let's say you step up and just do the mirror image with me, right? So this is like word of energy. This thumb or hukou is about your nose high and the other hand in the front of your chest. So you are on the sitting stance, okay? That's why your back is upright. Then you go forward, lay down your front foot, chop the front hand, and you go press, close your hands. Then your body get alignment, leaning forward obliquely, and then you got straight from your nose, knee, toes. 叫鼻尖、膝尖、脚尖、三尖相照. So this three tip has to be aligned. Yeah, so you stay here, build up your posture. And once you feel your front leg is sore, is tired, then you can relax your front leg. You sit back, training your back leg. Yes. And forward. Good. And backward. Right. You can check your back foot, see if your toe is close to forward instead of open. And your front foot, of course, need to be forward. And your knee don't point too far forward. Just arrive about alignment with your foot. Very nice. So just this exercise, if you can start to practice, is very good preparation for you to learning Wu-Style Tai Chi. All right? So I think for this session, Just know this much, and I have the brush knee, push palm. Those are involved with the walking steps. So you need to able to do the stationary stance. Then you will have to learn the walking steps, go forward, go backward. For example, how we can just try, but we're not gonna have time to do a lot of training. For example, we do this. This is how Wu-Style Tai Chi brush. Okay, am I back? All right, so earlier the screen tell me is disconnected. Okay, so I hope it's good now. Anyway, let me just go through this the brush knee twist step again. Then maybe hopefully next time, if I do the live again, or if you take our classes, then you will able to learn more. There's a lot of can talk about the Wu style. Okay, so we start from this position. Let's see, this is brush and push. So we go step forward. So this is gonna involve some hand move training and footwork training. So you may not able to get it by one time, but slowly, after you got decent practice and taking classes, everybody were able to do. See, this movement all apply with the bow stance and the sitting stance. Now for repose monkey in Wu-Style Tai Chi, is doing this way. You will need to learn stepping back. And you also apply the brush and the push. It's very gentle and a subtle movement to make you, your spine can get open, your spine can get stretched, settle. The good way of the stretch, and it helps for your build your leg strength. And it helps for improve your flexibility, also balance, okay? Talk about balance. You see that move forward and backward. Even though before you learn moving step, when you only train the stationary stance, it's already start to helps you. We say Tai Chi, all style of Tai Chi can be, one of the benefit is for fall prevention, but specifically for Wu style. Wu style Tai Chi has a nickname. It's called Tai Chi for fall prevention. Okay, so because this body position and the small step and the way you handle the weight shifting, so you go forward, you lay down and then you solid and you go backward and you empty and you make to the stance and solid. So all those detailed training, it helps for our nerve and connect with our like leg, the body, and for the reaction, for the position, for a lot of balance benefit. So, back to many years ago, we did some study research. So people like middle age above or senior, elderly, so training Tai Chi Wu style, specifically Wu style, to manage, to research, to following them, check their fall prevention, how to say, effective. It's really, really amazing compared to people even doing other style. The overall, people who doing Tai Chi exercise is already helps for fall, for like a sudden, the fall, you know, happening. But Wu style Tai Chi, the specific footwork and the body position, it teach you to lean forward and up straight, and adjusting this body position and adjusting your foot, feet position. Those is even more obvious than other style of Tai Chi. Okay, so just like we have the study, clinic study to research for sun style Tai Chi is most benefit for arthritis. Same thing, the Wu-Style Tai Chi is most benefit for fall prevention. Okay, so that's all comes from the body, specific body position and the balance training, balance strength training. And Wu-Style Tai Chi has other nickname. The most popular one, we know is fall prevention. And another one is, in Chinese, 我们说叫脊柱拳, is a one specific form to maintain training our spine. So the spine health is almost like a, how to say that? Spine is so important, right? If anyone have the cervical spine or any spine issue, it can cause the whole body. It can cause the entire lower body, or it can cause like head, like dizzy, or a lot of problem. So Wu-Style Tai Chi specifically benefit for our spine, because all those movement you want to open longer, tiny, teeny longer. And then when you have this close squeeze and you have this open, yeah, then all this movement is super subtle and it's super detailed, and a lot of spiral and circle, small circle combined with big circle. Big circle go back to small circle. There are so many details. Of course, I cannot tell you by this one session today. Yeah, hopefully you have chance in the future to learning. Yeah, to get to know those. All right. So Wu-Style Tai Chi, we say spine, Tai Chi for spine health, in Chinese is more easy to say, called 脊柱拳. Translate to English is not like rhyming. It's not so smooth. And it's also called Tai Chi for prevention. And it's also called Tai Chi for longevity. We say Wu-Style Tai Chi is 长寿拳. 长寿拳 for longevity. Because your movement, like, even though you are 80, 90 years old, you still can enjoy Wu-Style Tai Chi. You don't have to squat low. You don't have to jump high. You don't have to kick high. You don't have to do all this physically demanding is less. But while you're doing Wu-Style Tai Chi, you actually get improved on your strength, balance, flexibility with all this small frame. It's called long. Yeah, 长动的拉得很长嘛, length. Yeah, we go with the length and the open, and also small frame and the high stance. Yeah, so just like people go, when we're getting older, your walking steps get smaller, right? You don't have to go big step like young people. Then elderly, they go small step, but as long as you're stable, like a turtle, they move very small steps, very slow, but they can move for a long time, right? Before they crash. So Wu-Style Tai Chi gave us the opportunity to train most calm, peace, and not that challenging, not physically demanding, but actually returns back a lot of physically benefit. Okay, so time's always flies. All right, then I always feel not enough. Then yeah, in this our fall session today, we just start our class, and we have some classes like this morning, the Tai Chi Flow, and Wednesday evening, we have Tai Chi Boot Camp. In those classes, I might involve teach some Wu style forms, because we're not learning any specific Tai Chi train routine. In those two classes, Tai Chi flow and the Tai Chi boot camp, I only teach students to get to know to all different major style of Tai Chi, and I got to explain the difference, and I lead you guys to practice to prepare the fundamental skills for those Tai Chi. Then once you get to know those, and you can choose, oh, what style I feel I most like. Some people might like the Sun style best. Some people might like the Yang style best. And some people might like Wu style. That's why we have that two classes. Is generally I give you all the information. Then you get to taste everything. Then in the next session or later, then you can choose, oh, I might want to learn more specific form. Then also in this session, we do have Yang style Tai Chi 24 form class on Thursday morning. Then you just, in that class, we're not talking about Wu style. We're not talking about Chen style. You focus on learning Yang style 24 form. And on Saturday morning, okay, it's also in person and online together. We teach this Wu-style Tai Chi 24 form. So Wu-style Tai Chi 24 form. I have the 24 form series of curriculum. So you have Yang style, Wu-style, Chen style, and Sun style. Each style, you learn fundamental and 24 form. After that, you can learn intermediate level, longer form. And you learn longer form. Yeah, that's advanced. And you learn weapon for this style. Yeah. So if you are interested learning Wu style, I highly recommend you take a look our schedule. If you can, if you can make it, Saturday morning, 8:30 to 9:30 Pacific time, California Pacific time, we have Wu style Tai Chi 24. That's perfect class for beginner to learn. If you already done Wu style, you learn like a 13 or 24 form already, or even though you learn Wu style long form already before, you want to improve, then you can try Sunday morning, 8:30 to 9:30 Wu style. That's intermediate to advanced level. So that in that class, you learn Wu style 37. 37 form is a signature form for Wu style. Yeah. And 93 is Wu style long form. That's next session maybe, okay, after this level. So if you, again, you also, if the online classes and the in-person classes are not meet for your schedule, we also have this DVD, instructional DVD. I just released early this year, so this spring. So we have online streaming version. If you don't have a player to play the DVD, and then we have, it's English and Mandarin, Chinese Mandarin, two language. Yeah. So in this video, instructional video, I explain each steps, and I even explain, have a whole chapter to teach you all those fundamental, from the hand move to stance to footwork to step. So this whole chapter to teach you fundamental, then each movement step by step from different angle, front view, back view, side view, just like how you take my class. But taking class, the benefit is right now I cannot see you unless you're here, right? Then if you take the Zoom class, even though you're far away, you can, as long as you turn on your camera, I can see you, I can give you a correction, you can ask in question during the class. So even though you cannot take the class live, as long as you are our you sign up our class, then you can have our recording video for each class, for every class, and to last for the entire semester. Then you miss any class, or if any class you didn't get some points, you have questions, you can ask me, sending me email. Then at the next class, I will answer your question, and I will specifically help you, you know, on the certain area. Okay, that's why I hope you enjoyed today this introduction session. If you're interested about Wu-Style Tai Chi, or if you're interested other style, like Yang style, Sun style, Chen style, other Tai Chi, welcome to check out our website. And for video, you might, so far right now, we don't have the video connected with our new website yet. But right now, from wuamintaichi.com, you can find the video. Then for the classes, you want to take our class, please visit our opentaichi.org. Yeah, the all the classes schedule is there. Okay, and yeah, follow our channel. And next time I will see you again for the live, for the YouTube live. Or I'll see you in our class. Okay. All right. Thanks everyone for attending today's session. Enjoy the rest of your day.